Hello friends, I'm Paulshinn. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, what is undoubtedly the boomerest automotive channel on all of YouTube. For those of you in the know, this is Operation Hooptie, or Athena as it's been called, because this is the Queen of Greece. Well, this car started out as a project between my dad and I. We bought it a few years back thinking we'll fix it up because it sat for 15 years and maybe we'll enjoy it or something, but we never did. So we finally got around to starting to go through this thing, figuring out just how clapped out this thing was. If you see the previous videos, you'll see that the underside of this car was dirtier than a Nicki Minaj video. And this thing had kind of been decorated by, it looked like Liberace got a J.C. Whitney catalog and just stuck everything he could on here. So what we've been doing is trying to turn this car from Hooptie into something kind of respectable that maybe not could be a daily driver, but at least would be reliable enough for, you know, the monthly club tours. So as we progress through this, we've gone through brakes, we've gone through checking the engine and the drivetrain components, everything like that. We're kind of just down to wiring, because the wiring on this looks like somebody mixed spaghetti and Crayola markers. So we decided rather than try and fix the wiring in this, it was just too far gone. We're gonna rip it all out and put in a brand new wiring harness. And while putting in this harness, I'm also gonna be converting this car from 12 volts back to 6 volt positive ground, the stock electrical configuration. Now that the battery's been disconnected, it's time to get started. The heart of the Model A electrical system happens right at the base of the steering column. It's the light switch, or as we call it, the electrical wafer. That is where we gotta start. So we'll start by taking the bail off here. Of course, in this case, the entire switch just falls apart in my hand. So this is the main part of the Model A wiring system. And as you can see on this one, it's pretty clapped out. And it's really oily, which means the steering box is still leaking. Which, oddly enough, because there's no drips on the floor under this car. This car is amazingly drip-free, but this is pretty oily. So I've got to pull all this apart. Start ripping this wiring out. It's been a couple weeks since the last time you saw me here in the shop working on Athena, and some progress has been made, I'm glad to report, but not a lot. But one thing that is happening is I've got the interior mostly cleaned out. And you can see I took some old seat belts I found on the shelf and I installed those, since somebody had already made holes in the car and everything for them. So Athena will now have seat belts. All that old weird wiring is gone now. Most of it's laying on the floor. Unfortunately, some of it ended up in the garbage, because they would make like a 4 foot run of wire out of 15 splices. But anyway, you can see some of the wiring kind of just kind of hanging around under there. Most of the excess wiring that didn't need to be there is gone out of the interior. One thing I am going to take care of today that really has nothing to do with wiring, because unfortunately I can't get a lot done in the shop. It's been crazy hot in the shop every day for a month. I really need to get that air conditioner installed. But one of my big pet peeves is when people install these wings on their motor meter, they always put them on backwards. I mean, if you look at these, assuming these were actual wings, okay, what you would see is feathers here that would go the same direction as the airflow over them, right? But people always put these stupid things on backwards on the cars. So if you're driving forward, air's flowing this way, the feathers would be doing this, wouldn't they? Anyway, I'm gonna rip these off. I'm sick of that. That'll make me feel better right there. Then I'll feel like I got something done today. I've already mentioned how I'm gonna convert this back to 6 volt positive ground. So that means I'm also gonna have to change this. This 12 volt alternator's gotta go. Haven't decided yet whether or not I'm going to change this to a 6-volt positive ground alternator, or just put another 6-volt positive ground alternator on it, or if I'm just going to put a generator on it. I don't know what I'm going to do yet. But either way, we can't have a 12-volt negative ground alternator with a 6-volt positive ground car. That's just not going to work. So this is coming out right now. One of these days, when we're doing a batch of alternators, I'll make sure to pull this out and show you how to convert this to 6-volt positive ground. It's actually pretty easy. When I say stuff like, I think Ray Charles could have done a better job wiring this car, here's the kind of stuff I'm talking about. You know that fan inside the car that was, like, I guess designed to cool your feet if you're driving? They needed a ground wire from that fan to a ground somewhere. So they ran the negative wire all the way through the firewall, through the terminal box, and then grounded it by using this spring clip on the head nut right here. That's how the ground was wired. And of course, it had to have some splices in it, of course. So this is just some of the wiring that I've removed from the car so far. That already is a lot more wiring than a Model A would normally have. The box of stuff that I've removed from this car is now just about full. I think I'm gonna have to start a whole new box. That won't even fit. Yeah, there's what's left of the modification to the rear axle. Come to find out, it was just some flimsy piece of aluminum that was doing nothing. I have no idea why they did that bizarre modification now. Absolutely no idea. There we go, the very last piece of Hooptie wiring out of this car. And with that, all the Hooptie wiring has now been removed, and it's all here in this lovely trash bag. There you go. That is now officially trash. So what happens next for this car? The next thing you're going to see is brand new wiring going in, since 97.3% of all the Hooptie is now removed from this car. I don't know, we're just going to give it some respect. We're going to do it right. So it gets a brand new wiring harness, and thank you so much to Steve Becker over at Burt's Model A Center for helping me get the proper harness I need for this, because we're installing turn signals, and we're installing it with an electronic flasher so we can put LED taillights if I so choose, and they'll still flash at the correct rate. It won't matter what the current drain is on those. So that's going in, plus we're going all out, new proper wire with the correct color code to go from the junction box to the generator, or in this case, I'll probably be putting in a 6-volt positive ground alternator, and the correct wiring harness to go between the dash panel and the junction box. So that is all going to be brand new and going to be in the next episode. Yes, I'm turning this into a two-parter. It just took way too long to do this. And who knows how long it's going to take me to do the new wiring harness anyway. So in the next episode, such excitement, as you will get to see me install a brand new 6-volt battery. You'll get to see me install brand new wiring. You'll get to see me install some 6-volt halogen headlights, possibly LED tail lamps. And one of the best parts is you'll get to see me convert a 12-volt negative ground alternator into 6-volt positive ground and install it in this car. And hopefully it works. So thank you so much for tuning in. I'll catch you next time on the next episode of Operation Hooptie and whatever else.